Hey, it's Judy Farmer, and here we are on Tuesday night, ready to do intermediate and some advanced Pilates exercises. How's everyone doing? My gosh, we just had Mother's Day, and it was a pretty nice day, but I know a lot of us are kind of isolated right now because we're in the stay-at-home order in Michigan. Some people are not adhering to that, and that's their choice, but I know a lot of my friends are getting kind of down because Mother's Day is really special. Isn't Mother's Day special? I mean, it's right up there with like Christmas. Everybody thinks it's very important, and it is. And just reminds me, I posted something on Facebook, and I noticed on Facebook a lot of people were talking about their mothers as if they're like superhuman or an angel or a saint or someone who can do no wrong and never has done wrong. And I'm here to tell you, after having seven of my own kids, that that cannot be the case. People say things to me like, oh, you know, like I'm some kind of wonderful person because I had seven kids. No, that doesn't have anything to do with it. And what has to do with character development, I think, is just practicing virtues and practicing good behavior or self-control or more love or meditating, praying, all these things that help you to be love to other people. And that's usually what people connect with motherhood, but not always. And so mothers like myself kind of have this innate feeling, you know, with the oxytocin hormone, which we love to get dominated in our brains through smelling flowers and hugging and kissing kids and loving our dogs and all that. Mothers, you know, as most of you know, we have more of a kind of a heartfelt love for our kids or for our families, or even if you're not a mother, a female does. But we're not angels, we're not saints, we're human. And when we look at ourselves and accept that, then life just gets better. It can't help getting better. When we accept ourselves the way we are, right? The way we are. So I've learned some patience through being a mom, but I still have plenty of times when I'm not patient or when I am indecisive and don't really make the right choice. And so in his book, The Road Less Traveled, oh, one of my favorite authors is from back in the day, it's a 70s book. It might come to me, but it's been a long time and I don't script any of this. He talks about decision making, and he says in his book that the harder it is to make a decision about something important to you that may have to do with a loved one, then the harder it is, the more loving it is. So when it's real quick and flippant to make a decision about something, that usually means you haven't really given it thought or taken it to prayer, if that's what you do, or really given it some time to percolate and come up with a better solution. Sometimes you just don't know what to do, and you just have to make the best decision and let the chips fall and then see how it goes. And it's always like that in our progression. So especially women, mostly women, watch my videos. If you're moms, you know, we are human, and we need to accept ourselves and truly not give ourselves any criticism. What was it today? I was starting to feel a little down today, and I was listening, trying to listen to what was going on in my head, and what it was a certain level of automatic self-criticism. Maybe you should have done this, maybe you should have done that, and that is a cycle that brings itself into negativity or depression. And so what we want to do is just accept our humanness as people, as humans, and accept our mom's humanness, right? There's been a lot of stories about moms who have been pretty rough to live with. I know Tony Robbins has a great loving story about his experience with his mother, and he had some pretty negative times with her as a young person, but that really shaped him. I know for myself, my mother had nine kids. I was the second oldest, and she started having children when she was 17. So we had some chaos going, and My dad was gone all day on the farm. He was outside all the time. He wasn't there. My mom was very isolated. And now, cool thing about having a younger mom is she's only 20 years older than me. And so she's still with us. So she's 20 years older and she's 78. So that will tell how old I am. So, and now, you know, we're best friends. And this morning I woke, I turned on my phone and I saw that she texted me at 4 a.m. just to tell me how much she loved me and to thank me for her gift. And it was just so, so beautiful just to feel our relationship right where it is. We are accepting each other right where we are now. So right now, you accept yourself, you love your body, get out your mat, and get down on the carpet, set up your computer or some other screen, and we're going to move every piece of this body, okay? So let's start with our nice shell stretch. I need to really lengthen my back. I was crawling around in some tunnels with my grandchildren on Sunday, and that was really cool, but my back was hurting after that, so we want to start with our shell stretch usually in Pilates. As we do that, we lengthen and we breathe in, exhale. All right, let's roll up out of that and get cracking. All right, so Alexa, play, and we're gonna lie all the way down on our side. Pretty. Let's bring our palm on our thigh and float our legs up. Squeeze them together so we're one straight line. Now, on the exhale, we're going to pick up our body and crunch the obliques. Taking your breath. Exhale, lift. Two and three and four. Rest, inhale. Exhale, lift. Two and three and four. Really feel it tighten up. Inhale. Exhale, lift. Up, two and three and four. Let's do three more for six. Exhale up, two and three and four. Keep your legs floating, don't let them lower. Exhale up, two and three and four, and rest. And exhale, crunch it, two and three and four, and down it goes. All right, let's roll up, flip over, straighten that body out, lift those legs up, palm on the thigh, breathe in. Exhale, crunch, two and three and four, lower. Exhale, crunch, two and three and four. Hit it four more times. Exhale, crunch, two and three and four, lower. Exhale, keep the legs floating. Really connect your ribs to your hips. Two more. Exhale, crunch, two and three and four, and rest. Last one, exhale, crunch, two and three and four, and lower down. Come up and sit like a mermaid, and let's stretch it out then. Lengthen and stretch. Give it a nice side stretch. On this one, we want to pull that hip down away and really reach forward with the reach sideways with the arm. Bring the rib cage forward and head up. Woo, that's nice. Let's hit the other side. Legs around. Get a nice mermaid position. Reach up. And stretch the obliques. So we work, we stretch. We work, we stretch. Feel it, breathe. Exhale, lengthen. Wonderful. Let's come on our tummies and bend our back. So tight glutes, long legs. We're going to come up quick with an exhale six times again. Squeeze your glutes tight. Tuck your chin. Breathe in. Exhale, lift. Two and three and four. Really pull that tummy in. Give it your all. Two. Two and three and four, and rest and go. Two and three and four. Really tight glutes, really bend that back. Two and three and four. Two more. Lower and press. Two and three and four, and last exhale. Two and three and four. Great job. Push into shell stretch again. Lengthen it out. Let it all go. So your feet are straight behind you. You're not crossed on those little feet. Take a breath. Still in. Exhale completely. Roll up. So my knee is hurting from being in the tunnel. So I'm rolling up this way today. Otherwise, you sit on your heels and you roll up to C curve and then stack your spine to toe. Let's go on our back. All right. From here. First thing I like to do when we get in this position is do a lot of crunching. different kinds of crunching. So today, one leg at a time goes up. Really straighten your legs. Today we're going to practice straightening your legs like never before. So we're going to begin with our 100, and I want you to lower your legs, but begin by pushing your lumbar into the mat. Try to make an imprint of your lumbar into your mat, like make a mark. You feel the fire, fire it up. All right, let's breathe. Tuck the chin, lift. Here we go, pulse. 2, 3, 4. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 2. Out. Pumping hard. Out, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 more sets. Out, 2, 3, 4. Curl up higher, 5. Exhale. 4. Exhale. 3. Good job. Exhale. Curl up higher. 5, 6. Last one. Exhale. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Rest and down. All right. Let's take our legs over the head for a breath in. Exhale. Over we go. All right. Flex your feet. The legs come down. Feel your spine stretching. So good. All right. Now we're going to spread your legs to a V. Feel the stretch. Bring them over. Still stretching. This is just a stretch. We work, we stretch. That's what we do in Pilates. Bring them back together. One more time. Bring them over as far as you can. Open to a V with your feet flexed. And then bring them back together. Good. Let's come on down then. And now we're going to practice what I told you about. That is straightening your leg like never before. I want you to make your leg so straight, okay? You won't be able to go as far, but you'll see it's going to be better for you. So we bring our chin down, we lift our head up. Okay, in that order, right? Straighten your leg, super straight. Other leg, shoulder straight. Now we're going to scissor, but I don't want any relaxed knees. Anyone who's doing this class should be pretty experienced already. So keep those legs straight. Here we go, and pull. See how I can't go as far? But it's better. It's a better stretch. You really feel it, don't you? 1, 2. 1, 2. Do not bend that knee. Keep them real straight. And 1, 2. Feel that. 1, 2. 1, 2. Keep going. Good. Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. Really stretching those hamstrings. Breathe out. Good job. Bring in your knees in. Rest your head down. Now one foot at a time comes down. Let's bridge. Tuck the tail. Squeeze your glutes. Peel it up. Get yourself all the way up into the bridge. Squeeze your knees together. Let's start with upright curls. Taking your arms back. Bring it in. Exhale. Squeeze your glutes. Keep your hips up. Curl up. Now you can see your thighs, hopefully. Coming down. Let's do 4 more. 2, 3, and 4. Notice the part that's doing the crunches here. Right below the ribs. 2, 3, and 4. Good. 2, 3, and 4. Last. 2, and, ooh, I really felt those. Palms down. Great job. Bring your knees together. Separate them just a couple inches. Here we go. Hands behind the back. Straighten the leg. Don't lift it. Good. Pick it up. Letter B. Reach. Woo. Bring it around and hold. Again, kick it up. Stabilize your torso. Exhale and bring that leg around. I'm making it sort of a backward V. You watch the shape. Keep those hips up. Feel the weight as you're carrying it around. One more. Exhale. And around it goes. Place your foot down. Hit the other side. The supportive leg really matters on this one. So straighten the other leg. Here we go. And lift. Pull it away. Inhale, lift. Try to keep that leg really straight. Exhale, down. And kick. Exhale, down. And lift. 3 more. 3. So heavy. 2. Working your abs in different ways, right? 1. Well done. Let's keep those hips up. We're going to release your hands. Now we're going to do our hip rolls. Remember, just like the hula hoop, squeeze, squeeze, release, release. Now begin rolling. Push. Imagine you're turning that hula hoop around and around. really pushing through your glutes into the pelvis. Want to tire yourself out here. Great job. Keep going. Are you getting fatigued? Come on. We can do some more. Okay, so we're rolling the hips. Beautiful. Figure eight motion. The way that we were meant to move the hips. All right, pause. Let's start with the other side now. Squeeze, squeeze, release, release. Got it? Now you just continue with the rolling of the hips. Keep going. Push, 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 push. Good. Swish, swish, just like the hula hoop. Keep it going. Ooh, you feel it in your back? I do. Feel it in my back. Feel it in a lot of places. Oh, woo. Need a break from that one. Let's come down slow. Push down in your ribs. Then come down into the lumbar. Curl down. And then when your sacrum hits the mat, release your glutes. Now you feel how your hips are very relaxed now. Good. So you want to keep them that way because we're going to straighten our legs up. We're going to reach. Arms back. Now with this one, we're going to do some roll-ups. Keep your glutes tight. Use your abs. This is all about the abs, not so much about the neck. We lift the arms up low. Woo-hoo! Stretch. Take your time. Let's do some more in and out. Stretch. Supposed to flex your feet here. Three. Reach. Relax that, thumbs down. And resist.
Your feedback is safe.
Keep going. Reach. Make it hard for yourself. Keep your arms all the way up and carry your weight forward if you can. Let's do two more, please. Reach. And one. Reach. Great. Pull my pants back up. Ready to continue. Sitting up tall, we're going to go ahead with the backward push-ups now. Really push it up for eight. We go up and one. One and two and three. Woo, my arms are tight. Exhale. One, two, and three. One and two and three. Keep it going. One and two and three. Again. One and two and three. One and two and three. Two more. Powerful. One, two, three. And one. One and two and three. And well done. Sitting down, spine stretch forward with the crown of the head coming forward. Lengthen first. Pulse here. Feel the length as you're flexing your feet. All right, now we're going to add arms and really reach forward and stretch through the back as well. Breathe. So good. Grab the oars. Draw back in the canoe. Release. Throw your head down. Up and over. Grab the oars. Draw back looking down. Look. Down. Up and over. And four. Back. Up and over. Three. And down. Up and over. Great job. Two. Pull the oars. And throw the forehead down. And one. Draw back. Up and over. Down. Great job. Let's go back on our backs. Don't worry. I won't forget to do exercises on the tummy. Let's come up and do double leg lifts. Okay, so one leg comes up, then the other. Try to keep those legs poking straight today, flattening the tops of the feet. Nod your head, lift, fingertips in the skull. Elbows out of sight, out of your peripheral vision as we lower and lift. And lower. And slow lift. And lower. Lift. Great job. Exhale, lift. And three. Keep your spine on the mat. And two. And last. Rest your head down. Bravo, bravo. Let's bring those legs over the head. We're going to really stretching piece, take them over and over, lift, carry it down. Again, over, over, lift, control the descent, right? And over, lift, carry it down. Let's do three more of that. Over, raise, carry it down. And two, over, lift, pull it on down. One more of that. And over, lift, carry it down. Bravo. Up we go. Let's come up for open leg rockers. I love these. So, getting into balance point, poker straight leg, right? We're going to work on this today. We're going to improve. Taking the other leg up. Let's fall back and come up. Try not to bend the legs. Here we go. And fall. Use breath. Look. Breath is everything on this one. Fall. Look. Find that balance. Come on. Keep trying. Keep trying. Look. All right. Let's continue. Fall. Look. You don't have to have your legs spread far apart. Just about the width of your mat. Maybe a little wider. Balance. Now, when we come up for the next one, we're going to step and balance. Hold. Get your bearings. I'm going to take the hands off and put them back on. Breathe in. Exhale, teaser. Two and three and four. Feel your belly work. In. Exhale. Two and three and four. Three. Go. Two and three and four. Four. Let's do seven. Lucky seven. Two and three and four. Five. Up. Two and three and four. It's in the struggle. Six. Two and three and four. And seven. Feeling my abs working here. I hope you did too. I hope you did too. All right. Let's try some push-ups right now. I hope you're beginning to sweat because I am. Sweating's always good, right? Don't complain about sweating. It's a healthy thing. All right, let's find your bearings. Getting into your plank. Elbows bend. Then straighten. Use your breath. Elbows bend. And three. And four. Let's do eight again. Five. Six. Seven. Last one. Big breath out on the lift. Shelf stretch. Take care of your back. Lengthen it out before we continue. All right, let's come down on the tummy. All the way down and lengthen. Hands on the side. Now, this one, it seems easy. Looks easy, but it's not. We're going to bring our arms out to the letter T and then all the way to Superman. We're going to go slow. We're going to keep our legs engaged. Keep our legs sort of lifted. Turn out at the knees. So you're going to come up into dart, which is a yoga pose. This is dart. So this is work. You should be working. Every muscle in your body should be engaged to hold your body up like this. Then we're going to take it forward all the way to Superman slow. Breathe. Exhale, slow we go. Slow we go. Bring it all the way to Superwoman. Stretch. Breathe. Slowly coming down. Keeping the chin tucked. Strengthening your back. All right, let's do two more. Tight glutes, lift that tummy, and slow. Trying to model this perfectly. Gotta keep that chin tucked. Reach, reach. Reach, slow, slow, and come down. Using counter resistance. Imagine that you're pushing against something. One more. Slow. Keep the shoulders down, away from the ears. You are reshaping your upper body through these beautiful movements. Breathe out. Slow. All right, let's clasp the hands. Bend the knees and tap. One, and two, and three, and pull. Squeeze shoulders. Let's do five more. Elbows out. One and two and three. Good. Keep going. Now lift your chin. One and two and three. Pull. Squeeze. Lengthen. Two and one and two and three. And one more then. And one, two, three, and pull. Shell stretch would be good. Let's lengthen that spine back up again. Woo. Feels good. We're still going strong. Roll up. Stacking your vertebra. Good. Let's come into side plank. We are going to come right up into side plank. You can come on your forearm or your hand like me. Two straight legs come up, modify if you'd like. And up we go, all the way up. And we're gonna move. We're gonna move slow. We're gonna create deliberate slow movement to strengthen our shoulder. We're gonna do about 8 or 10 of these. Simple movements done thoughtfully. You can rush through it, but you won't get the same benefits. Good. And good. Three. And two. Now we're gonna do number 10. And 10. And I'm gonna give my hand a break. Rub it out. Great job, you guys. Let's keep going. Let's hit this and give our bodies a great workout. Come on up. We're gonna do the lower lift. We collapse the shoulder, and then we put it back in place. Collapse it, put it back. Collapse, and three, four. This is a great oblique exercise too. And six, seven, eight, nine, and good. Woohoo, congratulations. Got those done. Keep practicing. You'll get stronger. You'll get stronger. You are getting stronger. Why don't we stay on our side then? And come out into pike. Put your head in your hands. And let's move. We're going to do switch. We're going to do scissors where we switch and hold and stretch the leg. Remember, today's theme is pull the straight leg. Hold them up. Switch. Switch. Notice how my leg isn't lifting up. You don't want to do this. You want to create balance and symmetry and link properly in your muscles here by doing it right. And reach, reach, and exhale. Let's do one more. Reach and exhale. Go right into the flutter kick now. So you can keep up with these bongos and this cool song. Flutter, flutter, flutter. Flutter kick. Try to go fast. Move from your hips, not your knees, not your ankles. It's hard. It's a lot of work. All right, squeeze together. Let's lower and lift for 10. Keep your feet in front of your mat. 9, 8. That bottom leg is the controller. Push your movement into your bottom leg. Think about your bottom leg, and you will improve your form. 5, 6, 7, 8, good, 9, and 10, lower down, big circles, reach it behind you, go slow, and back, lift it to the sky, pull it as far as you can forward, 2 more sets, forward, pull, reach, 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 and down, inhale back, lift, pull it on down. Excellent. 1 more set. Really cranking and lengthening. And down and back. And lift. And well done. I feel it here. So cool. All right. Love Pilates. Now, coming around, we're going to begin with the side plank and then do all those leg movements. I want to keep it tight, back to back to back. So you can reuse this video. It'll be your big time saver. You get your full workout in. Within maybe just a little over half an hour. Come on up, hand behind the head, and we turn, and we lift, and turn, raise, exhale, turn, inhale, raise, awesome, turn, and lift. Let's do four more. Four, lift, three, lift. Awesome, keep going. Two, how you doing? And one, and two more for 10, and nine, lift, and 10. Great, bonus. All right, I'm gonna rub my hand, blood flow. Clapping for you and I. Awesome. All right, we're gonna come up again. Ready? Here we go, let's collapse. Collapse, and up, and lower. Lift, use your breath. Blow it out. Four, five, six, kick it up and lift. Seven, eight, nine, bravo, and 10, lift. Yes, boy, that was good. All right, let's get pike. Pike position, legs in front. Get your torso engaged, hand in front, hold them up and reach. Exhale and reach. Inhale, switch and reach. Exhale, reach. Inhale, switch and reach. And exhale, reach. And reach. Good. And reach. Breathe. And breathe. Couple more sets. We're going to go right into flutter kick. No relaxing. And straight legs in. Flutter, flutter, flutter. Try to keep up with the music. Keep it going. Stable trunk. Stabilize your abs. That's the hard part. Stabilize your trunk and keep flutter kicking. Go, go, go. Denise, Constance, all my buds, Cindy, my new buds, Rebecca, Bianca, Olivia, go for it, girl. Your body's only getting better now. All right, that was great. Now what we're gonna do, let's go to double leg lifts and two. And three, four, cool song, huh? Five, six, seven. Feel that bottom leg do the work. The one on the bottom is your focal point. 10, wonderful. Big reach. Pull back. Bring it down and back. And lift. This is my titanium hip, you guys. It's a testimonial to Pilates. Keto and my wonderful osteopath who put my new hip in. I have the flexibility of a young person. Reach. Ooh, this feels so good. And let's do an extra set just because it feels good today. Bear with me. One more. Reach. Lift. Alexa, skip. Alexa, skip. We want some really fun songs. Okay, let's see. What do we do? I hope I didn't miss anybody, but I know someone, one of my good friends, will let me know what I missed. And thank you. I appreciate that because I get going and I forget some things. All right, let's see what we do. We need to do some good rotation, so let's do that. Let's do this one for rotation today. Sitting really tall, lengthen out your left leg, bring that right knee up. Okay, we're going to rotate toward the right knee on the breath in. Super tall, rotate. I don't want you to tip back. Cecilia, if you're doing it with us, don't lean back. Keep yourself really tall. You want a 90 degree angle with your leg and your torso. You want to feel yourself go a little bit further, keeping that foot flexed. Lift the sternum, changing your posture. Woo-hoo. Coming to center. Let's hit the other one. Sitting tall on the sit bones with the knee. Breathe in. Exhale. Rotate and go slow. And we go. Hi, guys. Keep that right foot flexed. So it's not about lifting the jaw, right? It's about lifting here. Bring those shoulders down. Just feeling that exquisite posture. So healthy. So young. Getting younger, right, guys? Feeling it? That was great. All right, let's find our backs and do some more ab work. Just muffin pulse, all right? We're gonna add a twist to it. We're gonna take our legs apart into a V. So bring your legs, see how mine, they're in a V, they're spread apart. Can't really see it from that angle. Maybe I'll turn this way so you can see it. Okay, so you can see that they're, okay, we're gonna come up and pulse, take breath. Nod your head, curl up and pulse. 2, 3, 4, exhale. Different from the 100, you guys, remember? In, 2, 3, 4, and out. Pull that tummy down. In, 2, 3, 4, and crunching right below the ribs. 6, and 5 more sets. Exhale. 2, 2, 3, 4, exhale. 2, 3, crunch. 5, 6, 3 more. Exhale. 4, 5, 6, and 2, 2, 3, 4. Exhale. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and last. Good job. And exhale. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Bring your legs in. Rest your head and neck. Great job. That was hard. Congratulations. And roll your head back and forth. Again, we want to keep our legs really straight. We don't want to compensate. Let those hamstrings tighten up. Keep our legs nice and straight. Okay, let's do another one. One knee at a time to the chest. We're going to take one leg out, lower it down. We're going to do 3 pulses. Inhale. 3 pulses. Or 3 pulses. Exhaling. And then inhale. Then switch. And exhale on both sides. Inhale in the center. You'll see. Nod your head and up. Fingertips in your scalp. And lift to the knee. 2, 3. Inhale. Inhale. And crunch. Lift. Lift, inhale, and low, 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 inhale, and really pick the chest up toward the thigh, okay, not the elbow, 1, 2, and 3, and 1, 2, and 3, continue, 1, 2, 3, and 1 more, 2, 3, and 1, 2, and 3, knees in, rest your head. Lift up. We need a little bit more work for the back. Let's do our partial tulip so we can really bend and stretch into the lumbar. Challenge our spine even more. We're going to take both legs out to a V. Okay. Sitting super tall. This is intermediate. I want you to really sit tall with your straight legs in this class. If it's too high, if you're all hunched over, you should probably be doing one of the Thursday classes. Take your right foot, pull it in, touch your inner thigh. And we are tall. Reach those arms up. Let's do shoulders up and down 4 times. Lift and lower. You're getting good at this, I hope. Lift. Keep her going. And lift and lower. Feel it? 1 more. And keep them locked in place. We rotate over the bent knee. Lengthen that up the leg way. And we tip to the side. Strong. Stay. Pick it up. Let's do it 3 more times. Rotate. Lean over, trying to stay tall here, tall, tall, good, and pick it up, 2 more, rotate, tip to the side, stay tall, feel it, good, and sitting up, 1 more, rotate, exhale, tip to the side, great, strengthen it for the back, and sit up, all right, let's switch sides. Now, speaking from someone who really does have spinal issues, I really do. My 4 and 5 vertebrae are crushed together and they're separated, which is possibly compromising my spinal column. The way to keep your spine stable is to keep your torso stable. So you want to do core work. You don't want to omit it because you think, oh, it might hurt my spine. No. This Pilates work is what has rescued me from serious problems with my back, okay? And that can be you. So tell your loved ones, they don't have to baby their back. They need to move it and strengthen it. All right, enough said. Let's take that foot in, touch the inner thigh, flex the other leg, and let's do 4 shoulder up and downs again. Lift, press it in. Lift, sorry for the commercial. Press it in, but you know, it's important. You can save your body. And 2 more. From so much early aging. You don't have to age. Okay, hold it. flex that foot, rotate, and lean. Lean it, lean. Hold it, do your best, pick it up. Great job, Denise, rotate. Exhale, stay strong, keep your chest up, your chin up, your head up. Pick it up, two more. Rotate, tip. Don't you feel pretty? Not the guys. You don't have to feel pretty, unless you want to. Don't you feel great? All right, let's do one more. Sitting up, rotate, tip it over. Oh yeah. And lift. Take your arms down. Alexa, stop. I want to thank you for joining me today. I want you to use this video a few times a week. Pass it around, share it. As you can see, there are no commercials. So what do you got to lose, you know? Keep your body moving. Before I did this class, I was not in a good mood. Some things had gotten into my crazy head, and I was not in a good mood. Now that I've done this class, I am. So you just got to keep moving, you guys, and tell your friends. Just got to keep moving. All right, thanks for joining me. I will see you Thursday if you'd like to do the more gentle class. Otherwise, I'll see you next week. Feel free to pass around all the other videos that are located in Judy Farmer Keto Pilates, and like and share. I appreciate it.